to admit, I have no idea how old she is, but it's okay, because I'm non-custodial. See, non-custodial parents only have to know three things: the name, the allergies, and the nearest place to deposit your paycheck to the Department of Child Support Enforcement. Those are the three things that I have to know. Well, but I'm sitting there with her, and she's got a Doritos, and she starts to hand Daddy Doritos. So I take them, I'm crunching, I'm watching, I'm acting. And then I turn to her, and she's actually just shoving them in Daddy's mouth. Okay, that'll go. That's what's up. And then around that 14th or 15th chip, I started to notice that the flavor quality started to alter. And you know, that crispness potential, that was a thing of the past. So I'm wondering what the heck is going on. I look down, this child that I had created is taking the chips out the bag and licking all the salt off of the chips and not handing them to Daddy, slamming them right into my damn mouth. Okay? I'll never say this again in public to anyone. But at that moment, ladies and gentlemen, I started to love my daughter a little bit less. It's terrible, right? I don't smoke cigarettes anymore. I don't eat pork. I'm not a perfect man, but I don't smoke cigarettes. I don't eat pork. And I don't really drink. And I don't do drugs in front of other people. But I do think that I found a new version of heroin called cookies. For a chocolate chip cookie, I would climb a mountain. I'm a black man. That's a heck of a statement. For a chocolate chip cookie, I would climb a mountain, okay? For a peanut butter cookie, I would remember to put the seat down. I know you ladies would like that, so the peanut butter cookie, that's the secret with me, I remember to put the sink down. And for an oatmeal raisin, you could bring back slavery. I'm telling you, I love cookies. All right? And I'm heterosexual, so I'm afraid to even look at a macadamia nut crunch. You know, who knows what they can get to pull my leg to see what can happen. I'm from the East Coast, too. East Coast, only a couple things you can do. You can eat crab legs.
Yeah.
You can run from the police, and you can smoke weed. I came out here, I got medical marijuana, football injuries, car wrecks. I got medical marijuana, and I'm like, you know, but I'm still concerned. Not because California doesn't have good weed, but because I'm getting it from the government, and I'm thinking they might play corners. So the other day, you know, I'm smoking a joint, I'm put it down, and I realized the TV's too loud. The TV's way too loud. I get up, I walk to the kitchen, I glance to the left, the bathroom door is open, and I see a bag of family-sized chips on the sink. Okay, some things been going on. I get to the kitchen, I smell something. Apparently, I've been baking a cake. I don't bake. I get back to the living room, I look down, my phone is blaring, I look on my phone is playing Naked bisexual midgets in the Serengeti that enjoy bestiality. I'm realizing that perhaps California weed is worth something. I love y'all to death. Hope I tickled you a little bit. Have a good night.